the Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse for CTN's live coverage of boys high school basketball. Tonight is the conference opener as the Coon Rapids Cardinals host the Elk River Elks. Joe Young and Howie Shapiro sideline for tonight's game, and Howie, kind of an interesting situation. The Cardinals with two non-conference games already, Elk River playing their first of the season.
Yeah, they were supposed to have a game under their belt. Eight players on this squad played football, and they, of course, as everyone knows, in the state tournament. So they had to kind of wait, postpone a game. This is their first conference, or first game, obviously, of the year, and it couldn't be better matchup for them.
And they are going to have to replace a lot. Four of their top five scorers out after graduation.
Yeah, their top scorer comes back averaging 6 points a game, and that's Jack Berger. And he's a good player. Coach O talked to me. He says he distributes the ball well, rebounds well. He's very aggressive on defense. And they're going to have to put a man on him, quite obviously. But Coach Clausen said, you know, coming back, we've got players to step up. We don't have a lot of returning from last year, but we're going to defend well, and we're going to be aggressive.
Yeah, Coach Ogorek credited the Elk River Club with being a machine that turns them out. It doesn't matter the numbers or the names. They're going to put together a great team. Cardinals off to a great start, 2-0. Got a big win over White Bear Lake over the weekend. And now coming in, wanting to start strong in the Northwest Suburban.
Yeah, as Coach O said, we're going to see if we're Northwest Suburban strong. As you mentioned, this is an opportunity for them to see exactly where they are in the conference. This is a good matchup for them, and this is going to be a test for them. So they're going to come out and play their best basketball.
Well, and they have been playing very strong. Lionel Warner, 20 points per game through the first two, and look for him to keep up that torrid pace.
Yeah, we watched that game against Forest Lake, and he had a phenomenal game. And this is an opportunity for him, again, to showcase what he does. But he's not the only scorer on this team. You look at Tyran Johnson, you look at Sam Carver, and other players can fill up the basket. This will be an exciting contest.
Well, if the Cardinals can get it done the way they did against a very quality Forest Lake team with team defense, good speed in transition, they could start a 3-0 season tonight. We'll see if they can get it done. Tip-off between the Cardinals and the Elks coming up next on CTN.
I'm Ryan Nagasu, 2010 Olympian and bronze medal winner of the 2014 U.S. Championships. I knew I loved skating at the age of 5, and now it's become my life passion. Find your skating passion at the Coon Rapids Ice Center. Classes are available all year round. It could be the place where your skating dreams come true. See you on ice.
At the field house and just about ready to get this one underway. The Northwest Suburban Conference opener between the Cardinals and the Elks. And Howie, a good crowd in the building and two great games to lead into the varsity matchup.
No question. You can feel the energy in this house, and certainly the Cardinal fans and obviously the Cardinal players and staff feel pretty good about where their team is. And we talked about in the opening, this is a good test for the Coon Rapids Cardinals. Elk River, always a team that's going to defend and be physical.
So look at your starters for the Elks. Wyatt Morrell and Noah Ouija in the backcourt. Blake Hills, Jack Berger are the forwards. Cameron Cotton in the middle. Rask and Warner, the guards for the Cardinals. Dial the wall. Tyrion Johnson are the forwards, and Sam Carver is in the middle. Tyrion gets the opening tip, but a big steal. Coming right back the other way, Wyatt Morrell, and he will slow things down as he comes across midcourt. Elk's first possession goes right side for Ouija, and down into the corner for Berger. Back to Ouija, up top for Morrell. Driving baseline is Hills, ran into some traffic. Back to the corner for Morrell. Up top and all the way across. That one stretched. Morrell a bit. He gets it back in the corner. Hills, rather, takes the three. It's off the mark. Carver has the rebound.
Nice job working the ball.
Warner wants to run the other way and does. He'll put the first points on the board.
Again, a quick basket by Coon Rapids after the Elks wanted to move that ball around the perimeter. Missed that opportunity. As Tyrion's going to pick up a quick foul here.
That's the one thing the Cardinals want to try to avoid. We saw that against Forest Lake. They got in some foul trouble in the first half, but in the second, able to control themselves a little bit better and get to their positions a little bit faster.
Well, defensively, the Cardinals are going to want to really play them close and try and get turnovers.
Three-pointer is off the mark for Morrell. Long rebound comes to Tyrion. He's on the run, and now we'll slow down left side up top for Rask. Warner High on the right side. Carver at the top of the key. Back for Warner, right side. Got some contact as he tried to get around the corner on Hills. And that'll be the first foul against the Elk River Elks.
You know, we saw that starting lineup. You're going to see it again here as Warner trying to gain that edge. Going to pick up the infraction, but Marcus Rask getting the start at point guard here tonight.
Carver tried to give it back. Now we'll kick it back up top for Dial the Wall. And Rask on the left side. Morrell extending the defense. Rask backs up right side for Carver. Across to Tyrion at the left. Berger stepping out on defense as Tyrion puts it on the floor left side. Up top for Rask. And now the Wall will back up against Ouija. Left side, Carver. On the wing is Rask. Looking inside, but Coon Rapids not able to get any kind of penetration. Continue to work around the perimeter. Long possession, but no good looks. Little fake from Warner, steps inside, draws contact, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
You know, you see that time Warner with a nice move to the basket, a quick move. He's going to get an opportunity to get a shot, but he's also going to be able to draw that contact. And if he doesn't earn it on the initial shot, he's going to try and earn it from the stripe here.
Warner just enough to make the first. Lane violation anyway.
We're going to get that on Sam.
And Elk River trailing three. Gets a little full court pressure from Johnson. Elks into the front court. That pass deflected by his own man, but recovered in the corner by Hills. Colton driving, kicks it out. Berger open look for three, and this game's tied.
Now, we talked about Berger in the opening, and, you know, he's dangerous. He's the leading scorer from last year to be back. Just was averaging six a game, but, you know, Coach Clausen was looking to him to really step it up this season and be a leader on that court.
Carver up top, inside to Johnson, draws a double team, faces up against Warner. And he's going to be called for lane violation. That's two of those little mistakes by the Cardinals early. Berger driving baseline, dishes back, big block, and the Cardinals running the other way. Warner, one on three, will kick it back to Johnson, steps to the line. Now we'll give and go back inside, and Johnson will put it home.
Now, nice job by Sam. That dish out back by Tyrion cleared the defense from the middle. Johnson able to find that little bit of an opening and a nice dish from Sam Carver.
Berger, 15-footer is good. And we're tied again. Johnson right side for the Wall, creeping out on defense is Ouija. Carver will take the three and he'll nail it.
Now, nice job, no hesitation from Sam Carver. He's just turned and fired.
Elks looking to answer again. Berger kicks it out. Colton, little jump shot, left-handed is good.
Well, Joe, you can see early on, this is gonna be a battle between these two teams. You know, they're very well disciplined, very well coached.
Another three for Sam, this time too much on it. LaWall nearly had the rebound. It's out of bounds off the Cardinals.
Well, that miss came hard off the iron, and LaWall just about had it, being as athletic as he is.
Morrell into the front court, left side. Berger, another three. This one's good. And the Elks have a 10-8 lead.
Well, Berger stepping up here early on for the Elk River Elks, and he's got 8 of their 10 points.
Johnson on the right side for Coon Rapids. Berger working him on defense. Cardinals move it around. Driving is Warner, and he scores.
Nice body control by Lionel Warner. He's able to hang enough to get a good look at the basket and put it in. That's 5 points for him.
Elks into the front court. All tied at 10. That pass wouldn't get through traffic. A good job getting the ball back. Berger underneath. Drew contact.
Off a late whistle.
It was a very late whistle. He gets the bucket and the foul.
I could call that on the wall.
I think this is the right call. I was surprised I didn't hear the whistle.
Just a late whistle, that's
before
all.
The. Yep. But an opportunity for Berger. I think it's the right call. He definitely drew contact.
He did.
And he's having a nice start to his evening. 13-10 lead for the Elks. 12:45 to play first half. Cardinals set on offense. Rask to Johnson. He'll take a three. That's off the mark. Rebound by Warner. Steps up. Gives it to LaWall. LaWall into the post for Tyrion. Kicks it out. Rask driving baseline. Tried to get it underneath to LaWall. Knocked away out of bounds by Berger.
Yeah, Berger did a nice job of getting in front of that passing lane and getting a piece of that basketball. Forcing the Cardinals to inbound it.
Carver lost the dribble off his foot. Berger on the run. Has help in Billman. He'll pull up and take the jumper instead. Misses, and Johnson has the rebound for the Cardinals. Warner wants a three on the run. That doesn't work. And off the backside, Billman has the rebound for Elk River.
He took that one from way outside. Could not get it to fall.
Nick Anderson back up top for Morrell underneath. And a strip by Warner as Billman tried to go up. Cardinals still trail three. Rask driving baseline, and he's going to be called for the charge. Billman getting in there to take the contact.
Let's take another look at that as he's driving the edge. Oh, he's so moving his feet.
Yikes. Not going to get him to take it back.
No, of course not.
Could have very easily gone the other way, and Rask would be headed to the line for with a chance to tie the game. Instead, he's headed to the bench to get a little breather. Elks into the front court with Joey Halverson. He draws a double team. Gets it across for Ouija. Right side is Hills. Very tight defense, and he traveled. Brandon Pratt coming over to assist LaWall on the main pressure.
Well, Coach Joe said, we're going to pressure these guys. We're going to do it all game long. You know, we're going to go after them. We're going to get them to create turnovers. You know, the Cardinals forced Forest Lake with 20 turnovers, 29 in the game against White Bear Lake.
Pratt right side for LaWall. Working against Anderson, got it back to White down low. Tyrion gets the contact. He'll go to the line to get two.
Tyrion comes into this game averaging 15 points a game and about 8.5 boards. So, you know, he's certainly active, and he's going to get his points. Nice move to the basket there. Just couldn't get it to fall, but hopefully earn it from the stripe.
Able to hit the first. And he hits them both back to within a point. 13-12, 11-15 remaining in the first half. Again, Johnson on the pressure, full court. Trap coming from Winston. They get it right side for Hills. Excuse me, that's Halverson, and he's turned over. Tyrion trying to find a hole, can't. Gets it to Pratt, cross court. Warner, open look for three. That won't fall. Pratt nearly had the rebound, but now controlled by Hills. Tipped off his hand by Warner. A drive by LaWall, and he scores.
Oh, you talk about athleticism, and Dial LaWall showed it on that particular play. He's able to cut through the defense, control his body, and get the bucket.
Halverson, again, draws the trap. And he's forced to travel as he tried to split the defenders and get it across to Noah Ouija.
Well, and that's paying off playing this pressure basketball like Coon Rapids doing defensively.
There's the tip away by Warner.
Watch
and LaWall
him drive between two
turned
defenders.
Turned on the Jets and beat him to the rim.
He did, no question.
Warner will set the offense for midcourt, working against Cotton, right side for LaWall. Tyrion Johnson now with Blake Hillis defending. Winston to Brandon Pratt on the left side. And now Warner again puts it on the floor against Cotton, looks for room toward the baseline, pulls up. There's Johnson in the high post. He'll back out against Ouija. Hills, rather. In the corner, Marcel Winston puts it on the floor. Now Johnson, cross to Brandon Pratt. He gets around the corner, baseline, got it to Winston. And it's tied up there by Ouija.
And good defense by the Elks again to tie that basketball. They had possession, so they'll take it. But the drive by Pratt, trying to dish it into Winston.
Morrell will get it back. Drive. Double team keeps drawing in. Cotton high post, back to Hills in the corner. His shot's off the mark. Rebound tipped and now controlled by Lionel Warner. And the Cardinals want to move. That pass tipped by Winston. He's able to control and then snuck it through the legs on Brandon Pratt. Pratt might have taken his eye off it just a little bit at the last second.
He did, and unfortunately went through his hands. He knew it. He was not happy with that effort from himself.
Hills to Cotton, high post. Underneath, a huge block from Brandon Pratt. And then LaWall ends up with the rebound. Winston down court, trying to get to the baseline. Can't find room, draws three, and gets the contact. Going to call the foul eventually against Blake Hills, but he had all ball right there, Brandon Pratt, and there definitely could have been a foul there on Berger.
Well, Berger, too, disappointed with himself.
I'm sure two opportunities.
He doesn't miss it from
in
close.
And then misses in close.
Yep.
Coon Rapids a one-point lead midway through this first half. LaWall back up top for Pratt. Right side, Warner with a screen. His three is good.
Yeah, they do a nice job working the ball around the perimeter, then working to Warner. As you mentioned, the screen gave him an opportunity to get a nice open look, and he drained it.
Seven straight points have the Cardinals with a four-point lead. Elks maintain possession. Ouija trying to split defenders. Down low, Halverson. Cotton in front. That won't fall. Second chance won't go either, and Johnson has the rebound. Cardinals on the run. Johnson not slowing down, won't get contact this time, and Ouija has the rebound.
A little out of control there, not able
Ouija
to get.
Ouija driving at the other end, he can't get it to fall. Winston the rebound, Pratt wants to push. Down court, LaWall for three, or Warner for three. Won't go, and the rebound foul is going to be on Tyrion Johnson going over the back.
Yeah, that'll be his second. Head coach Randy Clausen, his 17th season as the head coach for the Elk River Boys. If you remember,
Tyrion Johnson really does not want to come out of this ball game.
If you remember, Joe, Randy used to coach the girls Elk River squad for about 10 years.
Ouija drawing a crowd, gets it back to Morrell. Into the corner, Berger from 17, won't go. Halverson can't control the rebound. Cotton lost it. LaWall pushes it for Pratt. Pratt will be given the charge.
Wyatt Morrell stepped up and doesn't look happy, Coach O. We'll see it again. That's a good call.
I think that one's a good call,
yeah.
But with the three, three on one, you have to convert that to points.
On a Samway in for Coon Rapids.
Morrell, trap coming, gets it left side for Halverson. Back up to Morrell. The steal by Pratt. Pratt down court. Ouija, the hard foul. Pratt goes hard to the ground.
Oh, he's.
And he is very slow to get up. And Ouija there trying to help him up.
Oh, he hit the floor hard. It seems to be all right. Going to shake that one off. Tough kid.
Well, Ouija right there to help him up, and not no intent there for anything else than a stop the ball from getting in the hole. Two chances for Pratt from the line. The first one will not go down.
Back into the Cardinals, number 22, Dial LaWall.
Dial LaWall going to check back in for the Cardinals, and Tyron Johnson will take a seat with a couple of personals. 7:35 remaining in the opening half.
Full court pressure from the Cardinals. Morrell to Ouija across midcourt, left side, Berger. Miscommunication on the run. LaWall had to adjust and he misses. Pratt a second chance. He gets it down.
Well, you saw three red jerseys underneath the basket after that miss, and they were going to make sure they cleaned it up and got that bucket. 6-point lead for Coon Rapids.
Berger down low for Anderson. Cardinals come up with another steal on the run. Lionel Warner this time avoids the contact, and what a pretty basket.
Well, he does such a nice job of hanging in the air and adjusting. And again, just getting the buckets. That's 10 points halfway to his average, and we're still...
Made sure there was no contact, no chance of a charge this time around. Sidesteps and just kisses it over the rim. 11-point run for the Cardinals, a 21-13 lead.
But you know, contribute a lot of this to just being aggressive defensively and creating those turnovers. That's the thing Coach O talked to me about, and he said what we need to do tonight against a team so good defensively is we need to be good defensively, create those turnovers, and then turn those turnovers into points. And that's what they have done here this evening so far. Well, Joe, we had a quick show last night on Sports Night. We're going to have another show next on Monday. And probably have, I would imagine, we'll have a little more video to show everybody.
Well, we're going to have the long-awaited swimming and diving preview.
Yes.
Mr. Millington will be visiting with that Cardinal group on Wednesday evening.
Love that.
This week, and we'll bring you something on that. I'll see what I can do about Nordic ski. But right now, we got a ball game. Coon Rapids leading 21-13, 6:52 to play in the first half. Red's in the house. Coach Adams is here.
Yep.
Coach Johnson here as well. Morrell throws it back. Left side, Ouija finds some room and gets it along the baseline. That's a big basket for Elk River at this point in the game.
Yeah, they needed to stop that Coon Rapids run, and they did that. And cut the lead to 6.
Warner thought about the three, steps in instead, and this time can't get it to go. The rebound tied up, possession arrow favors the Cardinals. That was Juan Asamway in there against Ouija.
Yeah, nice job just getting control of that basketball. They knew that they had the possession arrow, able to keep it.
Juan Asamway up top. Now Warner for 3. This time he can't get it to go. Punched at by Pratt. What hustle.
Yep.
By number 3 in red. He just punched the first one away and then chased it down and nearly got that possession back for Coon Rapids. Left side, Berger back up top. Now Berger again. Double teamed as Winston had tough pressure. Morrell. Right side, Hills into the corner. Ouija. And now Hills. Double team is there. Morrell stepping up. A lot of red jerseys converge. Good luck for Berger to find Hills in the middle for the empty basket.
Yeah, we talked about Berger. Not only can he score the ball, but he can distribute. And you saw it there, again, moving the ball around the perimeter and then catching Hills coming down the lane for the bucket.
Warner Backs out, resets the offense for Coon Rapids. Right side for Marcel Winston. Winston will put it on the floor against Ouija and now give it up for Dial LaWall. Left side, Winston, a little pump fake. Looks off Cotton a bit and won a Samwe to Brandon Pratt. And we've got an offensive foul away from the ball. Going to be called against Marcel Winston.
Personal foul on the Cardinals, number five, Marcel Winston.
That'll be his first, team sixth. Five team fouls on the Elks.
Elks able to get the last two baskets, cut this lead in half. Now trail 21-17. Cotton kicks it out. Hills for three. That's short. Ouija gets it back. Leaves it off for Hills. A little give and go. And boy, did he hook, but then threw the ball away. And a turnover to the Cardinals. You see the two wrestling coaches and their captain right between them, TJ Mandy. And Red, of course.
Oh, yeah. That's a given for Red. He's always here. Always in the house. Number one fan.
Juan Asamwe into the front court. Right side for LaWall. Up top, Warner, long three. This is short. Foul underneath. It's going to go against Ouija. That'll be his second.
Number 15, Noah Ouija.
That'll be team sixth.
Noah's personal foul is his second.
Tyler Billman will check back in for Elk River.
Yeah, there you see the push underneath by Ouija.
Elk River, number 53, Tyler Billman.
Winston gets it into the corner for LaWall, turns and faces up against Berger, up top for Lionel Warner. Back for LaWall. Little pump fake, driving the lane, little hanging jumper won't fall. Warner battling for his own rebound, but Hills comes up with it. Juan Asamwe picked his pocket clean. And Juan Asamwe turning up court. And he's... And then he battles to tie up and at least get the possession arrow back for the Cardinals. Nice job. I don't understand how there was an awful lot of contact.
Let's see that.
As he, just a gorgeous hustle steal from Juan Asamwe. And look at all the contact he gets, but no whistles. Cotton clearly backpedaling that whole way. Cotton scores at the other end, and it's back to a two-point game. Lionel Warner will back out. Left side for Pratt. Juan Asamwe spins away from Billman and kicks it back up top for Pratt. Left side, Warner. 3.5 left in the first. Open look for Winston. His is going to roll around and come back out. Juan Asamwe, only one there, to challenge three Elks for the rebound. Elk River a chance to score or take the lead on this possession. Cardinals and Elks, big steal by LaWall, and he can't get the dunk to fall. You gotta put that in the basket. Quick look, Berger at the other end, and we're tied at 21.
Yeah, that miss by LaWall led to 2 points, quick points, as Berger underneath the basket all alone. The little defensive breakdown by Coon Rapids, and Coach O is going to call a timeout here with a 21-21 score. 2:49 remaining in this very entertaining first half of basketball.
Well, the Elks took a timeout, down eight. They have reeled off eight straight since that time and tied the game at 21. And Coon Rapids had all the momentum, all the emotion in the building.
They did.
But the Elks have taken a little bit of that back. 2:49 remaining first half. And both teams, as I was about to say, as Warner came up with the steal, both teams were already set to make a couple of substitutions. Rask back on the floor for Coon Rapids, and so is Sam Carver.
Yeah, Coach O went to a little more athletic lineup for a good part of that game. Both Rask and Carver getting the start. We've seen them on the bench for a little while. Now with the last 2:48, an opportunity to see if they can regain that lead.
Well, Warner on the bench for the first time. Carver working in the post, scores with the left hand.
You know, that's what they want to do, because the Cardinals have the size on the Elks, and they want to work that ball underneath, and Carver with a strong move to the basket for the bucket.
Berger in the corner, back up top to Morrell, defended by Winston. Berger got to the baseline, the reverse, too much on it. Anderson, a rebound, the wall, swats it away. Elks will keep it out of bounds. Yeah, is that Berger, you were saying about LaWall's athleticism?
Yeah, he's an extremely good athlete. And you saw it there with Berger trying to get that wrap around it. Couldn't get it to fall.
That was a pretty impressive play by Berger, yep, even though it didn't go down. Halverson back up top. Morrell back to Halverson. Left corner for Billman. Cross court. Morrell quick inside. Berger spinning. Fadeaway won't fall. The rebound by Winston. Winston wants to run. Pushes to Carver in the middle. Carver, the layup is good.
Yeah, nice job. And Sam Carver with good footwork, able to make sure he had that basketball and able to turn and get the bucket.
Elks slowing it down. Here comes that half-court trap. Cardinals like to bring a lot of pressure. Halverson into the corner. Berger fumbled and recovered. Pressured by the much smaller Marcus Rask. Looks for room at the top of the key. Morrell to Billman in the corner for three. That'll go in and out and then swatted away out of bounds. Should be Coon Rapids.
Oh, wow. Wow.
He took forever to make the decision and then came to the wrong conclusion.
Yes, he did. That ball definitely went off Elk River.
That's wow. So Billman, after swatting it away out of bounds, will get the opportunity to re-inbound it. Morrell will take the three. That won't fall. Pratt has the rebound off the backside. Coon Rapids on the run. Pratt kicks it out. Rask, little head fake, drives back out. Warner in the corner. That was the wall. Rask back up top for three. That won't go. The rebound by Cotton, who had good position. Final minute of play here in the first half. Coon Rapids with a four-point lead. Halverson gets around, tipped away by Pratt. And the foul is called. And that's going to be number seven, so a one-and-one opportunity for Halverson.
Yeah, big free throws for Elk River here. So they're trying to cut into this lead.
And it's off. Big rebound for Cotton. That follow won't go. LaWall, the rebound. That's a huge miss, and big rebound for LaWall. Carver cross court, LaWall for three, won't go. Carver couldn't get to the rebound. Morrell will control under 30 to play. Down court, Berger alone. Adjusted, and the late whistle will be on Rask. We'll put Berger at the line to shoot two.
Foul to the Cardinals, number four, Marcus Rask. Second personal foul at the free throw line, shooting two. Number 24, Jack Berger.
And Berger, a big free throw right there.
Cardinal substitution in number 12, Lionel Warner.
Lionel Warner checks back in for Marcus Rask, who picked up the foul. Second one is short. Pratt tips it back to Carver. Pratt pushes it up court now for Warner. Right side. Now back around to Carver on the left. Back out Pratt. Long three at the buzzer is off the top of the backboard, and just a sloppy play at the end by the Cardinals. But they will go to the locker room with a lead, 25-22. We'll take a break and hear from Coach O right after this.
Did you know you can report problems to the city with your smartphone? Download the Coon Rapids app. The Report It feature allows you to describe the problem, snap a photo, and submit it directly to the city work order system. It's an easy way to report a pothole, broken street light, or other neighborhood concern. No smartphone? Then hop online and report your concern through the city's website. City maintenance problems solved the easy way. Coon Rapids, report it.
Welcome back to Roger E. Carlson, where you're watching CTN's live presentation, boys high school basketball. We're at the break. Coon Rapids Cardinals on top of Elk River 25-22. I'm here with head coach Micah Gork. And coach, you talked about one of the things you want to do today is create turnovers and then capitalize on that. You guys did a nice job of that in the first half.
We did. I mean, you know, it's Elk River. They're really solid. I wish we could create more. There's a couple opportunities where you think they're there, and they're really fundamentally solid and take care of the ball. But yeah, that's been the key for any points we've had.
You were up by 8. They did a nice job of cutting it and tying the lead, and you were able to get that lead at the break. What do you talk to your boys about during the halftime in order to tighten some of that stuff up?
Yeah, we got to execute better offensively. Our offensive execution in the half court has been very poor right now, and that's something Elk River takes pride in. They're a great half court defense, and they're really clogging us up. They're forcing us to dumb looks. They're forcing us to settle. You know, obviously, we want to get the turnovers, get the easy buckets, but we're in the half court. We've got to run our stuff, and we got to be more of a threat. Otherwise, they're going to continue to choke us out in the half court.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half. We're going to be right back with stats and highlights right after this.
At the Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse. Halftime for the conference opener, and the Cardinals a 25-22 lead, Howie. And they had a spurt there where they got the ball moving, got up and down the court fast, able to put up an 11-point run and get a big lead. However, Elk River came back with an 8-0 run to tie it. Coon Rapids, though, getting to the locker room with the lead.
Yeah, and I think the key was to regain that lead and go back to the locker room with the lead. And Coach O talked about the fact that Elk River defends so well that, you know, we have to do more of those things to create turnovers and get additional points. But he has to be overall fairly pleased with that first half.
Very, very. You can never complain about being in the lead.
No.
Lionel Warner getting it done early. He had 10 points for the Cardinals. Elk River looked a lot to Mr. Berger, who leads the way in the game with 14 points, including a couple of three-pointers. But that big 11-0 run allowed the Cardinals to get the big lead. That was a 2+1. Dial the wall. On the run, Lionel Warner from behind the arc. And then Sam Carver, after they brought him off of their timeout. Cardinals went right back to Sam. Hadn't gone to the into the low post much until that point, but then went down there on back-to-back plays and back-to-back times. It was successful.
No question about it. You know who I was impressed with is Brandon Pratt coming off the bench. Played really nice defense, created some turnovers, gave Elk River some trouble on that as well. So he's another one of those players that coming off the bench contributing.
We'll take another break and be back with the start of the second half after this. You're watching Boys High School Basketball live on CTN.
Looking for a new home? Come to Coon Rapids. Down payment assistance is available from the Mortgage Assistance Foundation when you purchase your new home with an FHA 203K mortgage. Any single-family home in need of renovation or rehab can qualify. Find out more today. Call 763-767-6422 or visit the city's website.
We love our new home!
You're watching
watching CTN's live presentation of boys high school basketball. We're at the break, 25-22, Coon Rapids over Elk River. I'm here with the Elks head coach, Randy Clausen. Coach, talk a little bit about that first half for you. This is your first game. What did you see out there from your guys?
Saw a lot of mistakes. We got to be better with the basketball. That's one of the things we try to take pride in. We didn't do a very good job of that. I think we had 10 turnovers in the first half. And a lot of it led to transitions, opportunities for Coon Rapids. So we cleaned it up in the offensive end a little bit better. I think we'll be in pretty good shape. Defensively, we played well, and we knew we were going to be in for a battle, and we got to pick it up a little bit for the second half.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half. We're going to be back for the start of the second half. Oh, we're throwing it back to Joe Young. Joe, take it away.
All right. Thank you, Howie. About 30 seconds away from the second half. And a tight ball game, 25-22. The transition game is definitely where the Cardinals want it to be. They have the speed, and they have been able to convert on the run. And they want to keep the intensity and the tempo up because that is when it was most beneficial to them. And through the magic of television, Howie Shapiro next to me, just like that.
Yeah, I just wiggled my nose a little bit, and boom, there I am right next to you. But Coach Clausen said disappointing, 10 turnovers in that first half, and that's some of the things that Coach O talked about when we spoke to him, is creating those turnovers. And so I'm sure that Randy Clausen, being the good coach that he is, the experienced coach that he is, talked to his guys about what they need to do to get control of this basketball game, only down by three.
Well, here's the bizarre thing. Usually for high school basketball games, when that halftime gets over, it hits zeros, we're playing basketball. Right now, we're waiting on the referees. I don't know.
There's a buffet back there, so they may have a little mid-game meal.
Somebody has gone to find them. We'll be back when they are found. Well, maybe, I don't know. Maybe somebody didn't go to find them. I'm not sure.
You want me to go? I'll go.
15-minute halftime instead. We'll take a break. Coach is dancing. We're going to take a break, and hopefully we'll have an official soon.
Extra DWI enforcement is now being served on Minnesota roads. Don't be what you drink.
All right. Now that we have three striped shirts on the court with red and white shirts, it's time to play basketball. Second half, Coon Rapids opening possession, a three-point lead. Marcus Rass trying to force it inside, knocked away by Ouija, but stolen right back by Lionel Warner. Warner left side trying to get around Hills, and he will get the blocking foul against number 12 in white.
That's on Blake Hills. That'll be his third personal foul.
First foul of the second half, his third overall.
Warner, a little 15-footer, won't fall. The rebound by Cotton, able to get rid of it before he walked. Morrell up court to Hills. Hills will drop off for Berger, high on the right wing. Double team comes. Berger back out to Morrell. Left side, Ouija draws the double team into the corner for Cotton. Underneath, Berger, that pass tipped away out of play.
A good hustle by Warner. Yeah, good hustle by Warner to get a piece of that basketball and force the Elks to reset.
Three-pointer for Morrell is short, bounces away from Ouija, but Hills will put it home, and it's a one-point game.
Yeah, disappointed Coach Agoric didn't get that rebound defensively, and Hills made a pay, did a nice job of coming in and getting the bucket.
Foul underneath is going to be called against Cameron Cotton, working defensively against Sam Carver.
That'll be the second team foul, his second foul of the game so far.
Second. And the Cardinals starter second half, number one, Ariane Johnson,
Warner inbounds to Johnson up top for Rask. Warner in the lane. It'll be before the shot. Foul is going to go against Ouija.
That's his third.
Some foul trouble early here in the second half for the Elks.
Yeah,
two starters with three fouls.
I looked at a little bit of a grimace on Coach Clausen's face after he picked up that third.
Warner needs to get it out. Gets it to Carver, driving the lane. Shot won't fall, though, and Hills has the rebound for Elk River. Left side, little pump fake from Berger. Double team comes. High post, back out to Ouija. And now Morrell at the free throw line. He'll put it on the floor and spin to his right. Ouija, way high on the left side, into the corner. Cotton for three. That's way over. Berger took it right in the chest. A good look for Ouija. That won't go. Cotton the rebound this time. Works hard underneath and puts it up and in. And the Elks have taken the lead.
Well, the one thing I've seen change, nice offensive rebounding for Elk River.
Warner driving, gets the contact, will go to the line to shoot two. And Hills has four.
Yeah, I was going to say, and he's looking for an explanation from the official, but that will be four. His fourth personal. He's going to take a seat on the bench next opportunity with four points.
Great job working to find space underneath.
Absolutely.
Little fade away, got it to fall and puts Elk River in front. Warner will tie it with the first of two.
Well, we knew coming into this game this was going to be a good contest. Both of these, Coon Rapids certainly playing well, and Elk River, solid team. Even though they've lost a number of players from last year's squad, they always put a good team on the floor.
Hill sits down with four fouls. Halverson on to replace. It's a tie game as Warner misses the second. Morrell the rebound, and here's Halverson. And that one knocked away by Johnson out of play. Brandon Pratt will check in for Rask. Halverson set to inbound in front of the Cardinal faithful. In for Ouija. Down low, Cotton underneath. Berger fought through a defense, coughed it up. Clausen is completely confused as to how that was not called. Warner will score at the other end.
And he's letting the official have it, too. There's no question about that.
Well, there was plenty of contact, and it turned into a fast break for the Cardinals. Ouija battles.
Yeah, Warner. That's just his first personal, team's second.
Yeah, Lionel Warner's had a nice start to the ball game for the Cardinals.
Team's first.
13 points to lead the home team. Halverson steps in. Pass was off of Carver's foot. Yeah. Warner tried to go behind the back just as someone tipped it away, and it took out the possession arrow. Morrell into the front court. Pass taken away by LaWall, who's able to get around the corner. Drive, scoop, and it's going to fall. Halverson trying to draw the charge. Not going to get it.
Nope.
And LaWall.
And that'll give the Cardinals the four-point lead, 30-26.
Halverson backed away from Johnson. Morrell, high slot, Cotton turnaround jumper. Carver got a piece of it. The wall quickly up court. Warner, a little fake, gets inside, and how was that not called? That should have been Ouija's fourth right there. And now I think it will be as they go to the floor. No, they just called the tie up.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's, look at the contact there.
I mean, yeah. Oh, because...
Well, was it,
he had stepped out of bounds, Ouija, and that's why the whistle blew.
Yeah, I was going to say, because if it was a tie-up, it would have been Elk River's basketball.
Foul called away from the ball. It's going to go against go against Brandon Pratt.
Yeah.
Moving screen. And that's number three on
and
Pratt.
That's a big foul because Pratt's defensive effort out there has been stellar.
Morrell to Halverson and into the front court.
A Nice play by
It was a really nice play. The wall got there a little late and bumped him pretty hard. And Berger falling out of bounds threw it off of the wall out of bounds.
Wanasambe and Winston in for Coon Rapids.
Pratt Berger, you can't leave him that look.
He has 16. He leads all scorers.
Wanasambe. Cross for Johnson. Left side, Warner. Warner puts it on the floor, drives to the baseline, leaves it off for Johnson. His shot won't fall. And Johnson's going to be called for the rebound going over the back.
That'll be his third. So a little foul situation for Coon Rapids with Pratt and Johnson. Three personals each. Logan Severson coming into the lineup for Coon Rapids.
And the Cardinals, number 32, Logan Severson.
Severson, the 6'2 junior.
Oh, and just a technical foul on Tyrion Johnson. And he is very upset, but that is the kind of thing you cannot let get to you.
No. Well, he left the arena for a little bit. Coach Agoric went after and made sure he came back.
Berger will hit the first. Chance to tie it on the technical. Hits them both. Now Berger ties it up and has the basketball. 14:09 to play in the game. 30 all.
On the technical, of course, the free throws and the possession to Elk River.
Well, give and go. Weegee finishes inside.
Yeah, nice drive down the lane. Good job by Elk River. It's a 4-point swing.
Lionel Warner puts it on the floor.
To say travel. Timeout by Coon Rapids.
And a smart one for the Cardinals.
Yeah, just kind of settle things down.
6-point run for the Elks has them in front 32-30. We saw the momentum shift a couple of times in the first half. What it comes down to is who can have it at the end.
Now that's the key. Plus, both coaches making big game adjustments.
Elk River with the ball, a 2-point lead. Morrell will start up court. Evan Huntley getting his first PT for the Elks. Tight defense from Winston. Working around right side for Halverson. Wanasambe on him. Morrell back in midcourt. Halverson, double team comes. Here's Morrell now. Back for Halverson. Winston creeping in. Morrell trying to find room on the right side. Kicks it back out. Berger for Halverson. And he'll back away. Halverson, or Berger rather, drives the lane off the right side of the rim. Tips around the wall. Trying to push it. That was deflected. Recovered by Halverson. Halverson will slow down as he crosses midcourt for Elk River. Yeah, Morrell.
Good defensive play by Elk River. Get a piece of that.
Now Halverson back to Morrell. Billman will bring it back up top into the high post. Huntley kicks it back out. Halverson to Morrell. Back to Halverson. Morrell. Halverson. Stepping inside. Kicks it out. Billman on the baseline. And he ran out of room. Stepped on the line and turned it over back to Coon Rapids.
Yeah, getting good pressure boxing him there on the line.
Elkhorn substitution. Back in number 32, Cameron Cotton.
Cotton back in for Elk River.
Wanasamwe into the front court, gets the pick and gives it back to Severson. Lane violation called as they look to get it inside to Warner. Weegee, left side, Halverson, Billman, back up to Halverson. Weegee, into the corner, Berger. Berger will get it back, open look for three, it's good.
Again, good rotation, and you can't leave him open. He's very efficient from outside. The Elks now take a 5-point lead.
LaWall driving, gets the foul. It's going to go against Tyler Billman, his second.
It's perfect reason why you cannot leave him open. Jack Berger.
21 points now tonight.
Yeah. Nice ball player.
Warner to get it in, has to go up top for the wall over Billman. Severson went the wrong way. Wanasamwe able to recover. He drives to the lane, gets contact, and will go to the line to shoot two.
So they called it, what they call this on Ouija? Talked about Coach Adams, Coach Johnson, and DJ Mandyke being in the house watching and supporting this basketball squad.
Going to go against Halverson, his first. Wanasamwe hits his first.
Carver back in for Severson.
Good high arcing shot, yep, through the cylinder, and it's a 35-32 lead. Halverson gets it across midcourt to Ouija. Cotton into the corner for Berger. Berger on the floor to the baseline, kicks it out. Cotton back to Berger. Jump shot is short. Long rebound controlled by Warner. Warner wants to run. And that's going to be an offensive foul with Ouija getting in good position.
We're going to see here, Ouija doing a good job of setting his feet, taking the charge. It'll be his second personal, team's fourth. Coach O pointing to his head, use your head, telling his players, make sure you're smart out there on the court.
Cotton at the top of the key, left side Billman, and now Morrell. Ouija puts it on the floor, tries to get around Wanasamwe, hands it off. Cotton, the 17-footer, that won't go. Rebound, Wanasamwe. Right side, Warner. Marcel Winston, yep, will kick it back. LaWall will get it back to Winston. Three-pointer for Sam Carver won't go. Ouija the rebound. Berger right side.
Leads back to five.
Berger scores, and Warner tried. That was a. He just collapsed there. They were like, hardly brushed him. But
we're gonna see it again.
Hey, try and draw the whistle.
Why not? You fall to the floor. You see the official may just call it on you. Cotton with the personal foul. That'd be his third, team at seventh.
LaWall at the line and shoot two. It's off. Oh, shooting 1-1. I apologize. Five-point lead as we're just about down to 10 minutes remaining in the second half. Wanasamwe is going to be called for the reach. Or the block.
13, whatever he did wasn't good. Official said, no, he can't do that. That'd be his first personal team fifth.
Got a piece of that, LaWall did. That's how Yoda would say it. In the corner, Billman's three is short, gets his own rebound. That won't go either. Hills can't get it to go, and finally tipped home by Huntley.
Yeah, on the boards, defensively, Cardinals have to do a better job. You allowed three opportunities for Elk River to get that bucket, and they got it on the third. 7-point lead now for the Elks.
Long three is good for Lionel Warner.
Yeah, they needed that.
A 4-point Elk River lead. Morrell to Billman. That's taken away by Winston. Warner couldn't control. Winston has it. Kicks it left side. Lawal, little pump fake, then puts it on the floor. Drives, kicks it out. Little pump by Warner.
Whoa!
That was a beautiful move and a terrible call.
That is
my goodness. What a great fake.
Watch it again.
By Lionel Warner.
That's unfortunate.
Wow.
Yeah, you hate when officials take a pretty play away from you like that.
What does Samway got a hand in on the... And then he got it out off...
Oh! Looked like he held him. It looked like he held him and pushed him before so he couldn't get to the basketball.
Wow.
We'll see it again.
How do you not? How do you not see that?
It's right in front, right? The official's right there.
Wow.
That's two poor calls.
Right. And a lot of bad calls in the game.
Yes.
And they seem to have been. Yeah, but they seem to have been more heavily slanted in the favor of the opponent. Great drive on the baseline by Warner, back to a 2-point game. Hills at the other end can't finish. Berger, great rebound and put back.
Got to do a better job of boxing out. They can't let Berger get that look like that. Untouched for the rebound in the basket. 4-point lead now for the Elks.
Little over 8 minutes remaining here in the second half. Juan Asamoah, right side for Winston. Juan Asamoah. Winston. Carver back out. Long three for Warner won't fall. The rebound by Huntley. Berger. The three won't go. Huntley.
They call it a jump ball.
What? He's saying, I guess, that Huntley was tied up before he threw it down out of bounds.
See it again. There's the miss.
Saying that he couldn't tell which one basically had a hand on it last.
Yeah. It may look
and
like,
I guess.
I think Warner may have had the last hand.
It looks like Warner's hand.
Yep.
Initially, it didn't look like Warner's hand came down with the ball as much, to me anyhow. But either way, it's Elks basketball with a 4-point lead, under 7.5 minutes left. Halverson, pressured by Juan Asamoah, picked up the basketball, needs help, gets it from Ouija. Ouija will leave it with Morrell. Back to Halverson. Halverson trying to find room on the dribble and a timeout, Elk River.
So with a little under 7 minutes remaining and a 4-point lead, the Elks are going to call timeout, talk about it with possession of the basketball. Wants an opportunity to try and set something up here. There you see Coach Clausen drawing something up for his squad on this possession. Coach O making sure that he instructs his team defensively what he wants to do.
What he instructs them to do is go home and watch. They can see the whole game again
on
YouTube. YouTube.com/CTN Studios. That's where these broadcasts live on into the future.
from now into eternity.
Well, I don't know about eternity, but for
they'll
a
be
while.
In a vault somewhere. They're going to be in a vault somewhere, some maybe time capsule. They'll dig it up in 100 years. We'll still be doing this.
In how many years?
100.
100 years. 100 years from now, we may need assistance getting in and out of the building.
Hey, listen.
Red is definitely a dance-aholic.
Yes, he is. Rock out, Red.
The fans have been treated to a good one here tonight. 4-point lead right now for Elk River. Ouija underneath to Berger. Nice pass to Cotton, driving for the basket.
You know, you're so concerned about Berger that you had a couple of defenders collapse down and a nice little dish for the bucket. 6-point lead for Elk River.
Brandon Pratt on the right side. First time we've seen him since picking up his third. Warner's three is off. Pratt has the rebound and the contact from Cotton going over the back.
That's four on Cotton.
Great positioning by Brandon Pratt. He's just so quick.
Yeah, he really
and he
is.
He hustles and he's a smart ball player.
Yes,
so he gets
is.
There when your back's turned, you don't even know he's there. And all of a sudden he's got position on the much larger Cotton and forcing Cotton out of the game. They'll bring Huntley back in.
As well as Blake Hills.
Rask back on the floor for the Cardinals.
Yep.
Pratt hits the first and earns the second. .6:26 on the clock. And Brad hits them both.
So plenty of time, just a 5-point lead for Elk River. But again, getting the stops defensively. Four point.
Ouija high on the left side, back across to Morrell. Hills will take the three, it won't fall. The wall has it, and then is bumped from behind by Ouija, and that's his fourth.
Yeah, so you have
the wall will go to the line and shoot a 1-1.
See it again. Good job by Lawal. Get the rebound, and there's the foul. Four starters for the Elks with four personals.
And from here on out, this will be a 1-1, but from here on out, it'll be a two-shot foul situation for Coon Rapids.
And again, these are important free throws. This is an opportunity to earn yourself a way back into this contest.
And Lawal able to hit the first. Back to a one possession game. Ouija will check out. Halverson back on the floor. And Lawal hits them both.
This is when all those hours in the gym practicing free throws pays
well,
off.
And that's two straight trips to the charity stripe that are huge for the Cardinals.
Yep.
Hills kicks it back out. Halverson will send it across for Morrell. Halverson, right side, and gets it back now from Huntley. Crowd coming alive. Elk River trying to extend their 2-point lead. High post, Huntley back to Halverson. Up top, Morrell. 5.5 to play. Hills back to Morrell. Hills at the free throw line. Kicks it back out to Halverson. Rask creeping out on defense. Left side, Morrell. And now Berger in the post. Yes, Carver kicks it out. We'll get it back. Thought about the three. Halverson now. Hills, Halverson, Morrell, Huntley. I'm getting tired of saying their names, to be honest. Halverson, Morrell. It's been a long possession with only really one effort at the basket. starting to remind me of a certain playoff game against the Blaine Bengals. Halftime score in that one, 12-8.
Barnberg.
Berger finally an open look, but it won't go. Pratt has the rebound.
Yeah, patience did not pay off for Elk River in that situation.
That was more than a minute. Warner drives and scores at the other end. We're tied at 43.
He's at his average 20 points. Timeout, Elk River. Yeah, nice job by the Cardinals. Good pursuit on the defensive end. And they give Berger that look. But well, it comes down back to this. And
credit the Cardinals on defense for a couple of things. One, that was, like I said, 1 minute off the clock in that one possession. But Elk River didn't get any good looks at the basket, although they were in the offensive end for more than a minute. And they came away with 0 points. And the Cardinals, in all that time, did not foul.
Absolutely.
That's a great trip down, and they quick turn it in to points at the other end.
The Cardinals are so quick defensively. They're able to really give pressure to Elk River, and it took them a while to find that look, but not able to convert, obviously.
The wrestling team is posing for pictures over there. There's a large contingency of wrestlers.
Love it.
And getting some of their young fans the photo
give me op. Give me a little FaceTime.
Well, no CTN jinx this week.
No.
We talked about two young men coming into this ball game, and they both needed to be big for their team to win, and both have been big for the Cardinals. Lionel Warner has done it all. He's hit from outside. He's played really well in transition. He's got 20 points to lead the Cardinals. On the flip side, Berger's got 25. A little jump shot is good for Cotton, and the lead back to Elk River.
Yeah, all three players with four personals back in the lineup for Elk River. Cardinals will look to go after them.
Warner colliding with Rask. Fortunately, does not turn into a turnover. Carver to Warner in the corner. Hills defending. The wall right side for Rask. Inside, Warner spins and scores. We're tied again at 45.
Yeah, again, nice job finding a little opening and finding the space for Warner to get the little soft floater.
Ouija spinning against Rask and now backing away. Quick shot for Cotton from the free throw line. Will go Hills. Great rebound. Berger gets inside, partially deflected. Quickly down court. Warner will drive and score. Coon Rapids back in front.
Yeah, he does such a nice job with body control. Able to hang in the air, adjust his shot.
And there's a steal, or nearly a steal, for Lionel Warner as he got the passing lane in front of Hills. 2:42 to go in this second half.
Yes, nice outlet from Sam. There's the adjustment, the hang, and the basket.
Pratt defending into the backcourt. Elks. Quick pass down low. Berger, the reverse is good.
Yeah, Berger's got a nice all-around game. He's got a nice shot from the perimeter. Does a nice job adjusting underneath for the basket. 27 points, leads all scorers.
Foul away from the ball is going to be called against Sam Carver.
Tyron Johnson back, and he's been out of the lineup since he got that technical. First opportunity coming back in with 2:11 remaining, and we are knotted up at 47.
Ouija to Cotton in the front court, turns and drives and scores, and puts the Elks back in front, 49-47.
Yeah, aggressive move by young man with four personals. He's got a dozen.
Warner drives. And the charge picked up underneath by Ouija.
We're going to see Warner trying to gain that edge, and he's going to go hard to the basket. Ouija able to hold his ground, and he knew it.
And you talk about a risky move for a man playing with four fouls.
Yep.
There's another one, but it forces a huge turnover when the Elks have that two-point lead. Ouija into the front court, pushes it to Cotton. Berger underneath. What a play by Pratt. Fall away by Cotton won't go. Tip by Ouija won't go, and Hills is done. Hills will be called for the foul.
Yeah, Coach Clausen not happy again. A number of misses inside.
What a play right there by Brandon Pratt, though. And then I think LaWall may have had a piece of that shot as well. And there you see Hills called for the foul. Johnson at the line to shoot two.
Now we talk about all important free throws. Here's
pressure
a couple.
Free throws.
Yeah.
Under 90 seconds to play, trailing by two.
Number one, Ariana Johnson.
First one is off the mark. And he missed them both. That one's short. Rebound bounces out, controlled by Morrell. Elks again with possession, up by two. Ouija. And Johnson going to be called for it. Getting him on the hand.
Now important free throws by Elk River as they want to increase their lead up by two with a minute 15.
1-1 situation for them. It'll put Ouija at the line. Lionel Warner is hanging out way back down court, and they're going to make sure that they know where he is with his 24 points.
Officials talking to the score.
They were double checking whether the technical foul had also counted as a personal.
So they're Coach Clausen is saying that
that'll be number five on Tyrion.
Yep. Well, Coach.
Well,
Clausen's
the Cardinals. The Cardinals coaching staff has them for four fouls.
Coach Klaus is saying Tyron had two fouls in the first half. Then
the technical foul.
Yep.
Which should be two.
Which should be two, and then that
would
be four.
Because the initial foul plus the technical.
Correct. And then he's been out up until the last 2:11, and so that would be five.
I don't count fouls, so I don't know that he had two in the first half.
I don't know that he did either. He was looking at somebody from my, I think, keeps scoring. Yeah, they're going to give it to him.
They're going to say that is the case. That's a big loss for the Cardinals, especially on the defensive end, what he brings as far as how much room he can take away with his long wingspan. Ouija at the line, an opportunity with the 1-1 to extend the lead. Oh. And wow, you talk about getting the shooter's roll.
Every part of the rim that ball hit.
Twice.
Yeah, smile on his face, I know Ouija's face. He knew the rim gods were on his side.
Hey, it's the second one cleanly. It's a 4-point lead, 1:15 to go. the wall in the front court to Rask. Long three-pointer off the glass and in. If you're going to take that shot, you better make it, son. And he did.
Under a minute.
Under a minute to play, one-point game. Rask nearly had the steal. Great effort. Cardinal fans want the 10-second violation and not getting it from the officials. 51 to play. Berger, top of the key, Morrell's pass padded away. Warner has it. Warner drives. Won't get it to go. Carver tips in. The wall recovers. Rask to Carver up top. Trying to get it down low. Dropping it in his dial the wall. Cardinals in front under 30 to go.
Now we see a lot of pressure here defensively. Al Carver's going to call timeout. With 19.3 ticks remaining. And this has been a one heck of a basketball game.
We had an exciting finish in Forest Lake, and we've got another one here.
We certainly do.
Great finish, great look from Sam Carver. Put that pass right where the wall could run onto it and take it in strong. The fans are rocking now.
They are.
...52-51, Coon Rapids has the lead. 19.3 seconds on the clock. Elk River has the basketball. Do you hold for the final shot? Of course you do.
Absolutely.
I wouldn't be surprised to see Elk River pass it around for 9 seconds,
yep.
Take another timeout. Both teams have to obviously focus on any rebound.
And don't foul.
No fouls. Morrell, right side, Ouija. To Halverson, a little fake back up top. Underneath pass tip by Carver, and the wall has it. He's fouled with 2 seconds to go. Dial the wall has a chance to seal it from the line.
Again, that pressure paid off.
Sam Carver got the tip. The wall there to control. Those two combined on the go-ahead basket, and now they combine on the steal. Foul's called against Berger. That's just his first. His first foul with 2 seconds left. He's got 27 points to lead all scorers. Dial the wall. You want to talk about pressure situation. Ooh. 2 seconds on the clock. It's a two-point lead. Do you miss?
There's 2 seconds remaining on the clock. It's going to be tough. It's going to be tough to get a shot off in that period of time.
That's why I asked. Do you miss?
Nope.
No, you don't. They need a three to tie. It gives Elk River the opportunity to take a timeout.
And the crowd is rocking here tonight. Coon Rapids looking to push their record to 3-0. And they are 2 ticks away from doing just that.
And that will equal their win total from last year.
That is correct. And then they have a game, very winnable game.
Well, right now, star of the game, Dial the Wall. And outside of Elk River hitting a very quick three to tie the game and force overtime, he will be getting the post-game interview.
Yes, he will.
Because what a pressure situation. Huge basket at the end. I think he only had... He had 2 or 4 in the first half. Yeah, he only had 2 points in the first half. So 8 points here in the second half. Everybody on their feet, final 2 seconds. They've got to get it the length of the court from midcourt. The three will go. The Cardinals are 3-0, and they have a big conference win in front of their home crowd. They have not had a win on the floor at the Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse in 2 years.
It's amazing. What a nice contest. What a good game. Good job by the Cardinals. You saw Elk River take control in that second half, and they built a little bit of a lead. Cardinals didn't look back. That didn't faze them. They came back. They got the win. They moved to 3-0.
Well, a very, very exciting way to start the conference and to start the overall season for the Cardinals. 54-51, they knock off the Elks, and it moved to 3-0. We're going to take a break. We're going to get a chance to talk to head coach Mike Okorek and also Dial the Wall, who is the man down the stretch. We'll be back with more on CTN after this.
So,
welcome back to Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse, where you've been watching one heck of a basketball game. The final score, Coon Rapids 54, Elk River 51. I'm here with one of the stars of the game, Dial the Wall, and Coach Okorek. Dial, I'm going to talk to you first. Big basket at the end of that game to change the momentum back to your squad. What was the thinking? What were you looking out for out there?
I've been struggling the whole game, you know, trying to get the ball offensively. But one thing he stresses to us is never give up, you know, keep playing, and that's what I did. Late in the game, made a good cut. Sam Carver, my teammate, made a great pass, and I just had the mentality to finish it.
We talked about what a great athlete you are, and you guys created turnovers, and that led to points. Talk about some of the mindset when you're talking about creating those turnovers and then going the other end and scoring the bucket.
One of the things Coach tells us is to bring the juice. And at the end, that's what we did. You know, you just get energy, you get up there, you get the crowd going, you clap, you know, and that's what helps. When the crowd's in it, that's what helps us get turnovers right there.
3-0, it's early in the season, but it's got to feel really good to be 3-0 at this point.
You know, we've been working hard for this, a lot of long days, long nights in the gym, and I've been waiting a long time for this, so yeah, it feels good.
Well, thanks. Congratulations on the win. Coach, you talked about what you wanted to see from your guys out here, whether it was a Northwest Suburban Conference performance. What do you think?
You know, it's great to get the win, for sure. There's a lot of things we need to clean up. There's no doubt about it. But, you know, I believe we have Northwest Suburban Conference perseverance. We showed perseverance at Forest Lake in a very tough section game. We showed perseverance here. We were down against a fundamentally solid team, and we found a way to scrap and claw and win at the end. And there's something to be said for that. We had a couple down moments. You know, I told some of the guys, you know, this is, you know, tough times. This is where we need to be tough. Here's where it is. Here's all the quotes and here's all the things. Now's the time to be tough because this is a tough moment. And our guys dug in. We were tough tonight and we pulled out a tough win here in the conference.
I know you guys stressed defense and your defense did a great job at the end of that game, really limiting what Elk River wanted to do. Talk a little bit about that as well.
Our guys brought some energy, you know. Boy, we just were really on it. I think the big thing for us is when we're moving, when the ball moves, we're tough, we're long, we're athletic. When we watch the ball move around, we're in trouble because these people in this conference and in our section, they're just too good. And at the end, just like Dial said, the juice was flowing. We had a lot of juice and we were just moving when the ball moved. And lo and behold, we got our hand in the right spot. We got our body in the right position and we got it done.
I know you're going to celebrate this win, but tomorrow in practice, you've got a game on Friday. You got to feel good, but celebrate this now, and we're going to see you on Friday. We're excited for that game as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we got to get better. There's no doubt about it. And for our guys, this is relatively uncharted territory, success for us. Well, here's the deal, okay? Our season goal wasn't be 3-0. Our season goal is, you know, we're not going to share it here, but we have a season goal. And we need to work towards that every day. Every step, positive and negative, helps us get towards that goal. And it helps when it's a positive step.
Congrats on the win, Coach. Go celebrate with your guys. We're going to throw it back to Joe. Joe Young, take it away, man.
Thank you, Howie. A big win for Coach O and the Cardinals. And what a second half. Coon Rapids came in with a three-point lead, but the Elk River Elks came in aggressively to start the second half, and they were able to get out in front 35-30. But the Cardinals come back, dial the wall, got hot in the second half, and really came on down the stretch. Berger was impressive all night. He led all scorers with 27 points in the game, but the Cardinals, as he talked about, just kept scrapping. Lionel Warner, 24 points in the game. He had just 10 at the half, so 14 of his 24 were in the second half. Marcus Rask, a huge three-pointer that at first you went, oh, that's not the shot you want, but it was. That was the shot that gave him the lead with under 20 to play, and then Warner gets the steal and gets the foul and ices it with the free throws down the stretch. And just really fun and exciting to be involved in any kind of close game, but to see the Cardinals keep at it, stay strong, not make the mistake that would cost them the game, but instead come up with the play to win the game.
No question. I was talking to Coach O just before we did that interview, and I said, you know, you've given us anyway two really good games,
yes,
close
absolutely.
At the end. And that's exciting, and those are some really good signs for this basketball program. Coach said, you know, we didn't plan to be 3-0. We have a plan for the season. We're going to continue to work it. But what a great spot, and to come in and get a signature win against a very good conference
opponent.
Very good
conference opponent. Now granted, Elk River in their first game they had some foul trouble through the second half. If they meet again, I guarantee you Elk River will be looking for revenge.
Well, no question about it. And Coach Clausen said this is our first game, so you know, we kind of know what we're going to get, but we're really not sure. This is now they have some tape, they have some things to work on as well, I'm sure, obviously. And but just a lot of excitement, a lot of enthusiasm around this building right now for this boys basketball.
Absolutely,
program.
The Coon Rapids boys basketball team is 3-0. They've beat the Elk River Elks in the conference opener 54-51. And it has been a joy being with you for it. Up next, we see them again on Friday as they host Spring Lake Park. We got some girls basketball coming up for you next week. But that's going to do it for this edition. There it is. Girls basketball on Tuesday and wrestling on Thursday next week against a big section opponent in St. Francis. But that's going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score from the Fieldhouse, it's Coon Rapids 54, Elk River 51. I want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. For the entire crew, including Al Shapiro, I'm Joe Young, saying goodnight.